हेलो, आई एम एसआर बसवराजु, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंग्लिश, जीएफजीसी, होसदुर्ग। इट इज ए वीडियो क्लास फॉर फाइनल ईयर बीए ऑप्शनल इंग्लिश लिटररी थ्योरी, सिक्स सेमिस्टर, सेशन नंबर 52, टॉपिक स्टैनली फिश इंटरप्रेटिंग द वेरियोरम पार्ट 2। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन we learnt about Stanley Fish's life and works and his concept of interpreting community. In this session, we are going to discuss a section of his essay, Interpreting the Variorum. The dictionary meaning of variorum. Having notes by various editors or commentators. First meaning, an edition or test with notes by different persons. Second meaning, an edition containing variant readings of the test. In this section of his essay, he discusses why two readers reading the same test arrive at the interpretation and why a reader interprets two different tests in a different way. The essay is the criticism on formalist criticism, which fails to resolve problems editing variorum of John Milton. Fish remarks the editorial procedure always ends either in the graceful throwing up of hands or in the recording of a disagreement between the two editors themselves. In short, these are problems that apparently cannot be solved, at least not by the methods traditionally brought to bear on them. Before going through the prescribed test, let us look into his contributions to literary criticism as they are relevant to the discussion of the present text. Stanley Fish's two important concepts. Stanley Fish is very well known for two concepts. One is affective stylistics and the second one is interpretive community. Affective stylistics. Affective stylistics refers to how reading of a text affects the readers and how these affects in turn shape the reading process itself. So it means affective stylistics refers to how reading of a text influences the readers and how these influences in turn shape the reading process itself. To explore this idea further, we will first have to understand that for Fish, text is not static entity. Text is not fixed thing located out there. Rather, it is dynamic, which unfolds over time as the reader proceeds through a particular test. This dynamism, this process results from the fact that readers bring their own imagination to negotiate and clear the gaps. So, Fish notes that the test is structured by the reader's response to it. The test is formed by the reader's response to it. And this structuring process unfolds temporally during the course of the reader's reading. As the reader progresses, the structure alters until the reader shapes the whole text. Fish shows how this method of reading helps us to resolve a problem in John Milton's Lycidas. a reading of two lines from John Milton's Lycidas. So, he must not float upon his watery bier. Unwept, line number 13 and 14. Here, the reader's experience at the end of line 13, perceptual closure is hazarded. Perspective conclusion is very risky, and a sense is made in which the line is taken to be a resolution bordering on a promise. That is, there is an expectation. There is now an expectation that something will be done about this situation. Something will be done about this unfortunate situation. And the reader anticipates a call to action. Perhaps even a program for the undertaking of a rescue mission. With unwept, however, the expectation and anticipation are disappointed, and the realization of that disappointment will be inseparable from the making of a new sense. Nothing will be done. Lycidas will continue to float upon his watery bier, and the only action taken will be the lamenting of the fact that no action will be efficacious. Efficacious means successful, including the actions of speaking and listening to this lament. Three structures come into view at precisely the same moment. The moment when the reader, having resolved a sense, unresolves it and makes a new one. This is his theory and dissertation, that the form of the reader's experience, formal units, and the structure of intention are one, that they come into view simultaneously, and that therefore the questions of priority and independence do not arise. The two facts of reading to be explained. The same reader will perform differently when reading two different tests, and the different readers will perform similarly when reading the same test. So, let us take the prescribed part of the essay. The concept of reader response theory says that there a number of indeterminacy in the literary test. The reader fills in those gaps from his own experience to get the meaning of the test. Then there are as many interpretations, as many as readers. This poses two issues. First one, the same reader will perform differently when reading two different tests. And second one, different readers will perform similarly when reading the same test. While reading a test, the reader uses and employs a certain set of interpretive strategies. They are the shape of reading. And because they are the shape of reading, so they give test their shape, making them rather than arising from them. The four possibilities of executing a set of interpretive strategies. First one, applying different sets of interpretive strategies to a same test would make different tests. The same set of interpretive strategies to different tests may produce the similar tests. Two readers put into execution the similar set of interpretive strategies on the same test would get a similar test. Two readers put into execution two different sets of interpretive strategies over the same test will make different tests. For centuries, the same set of interpretive strategies used to read Christian scripts result in the similar tests. God loves us. Our responsibility to love our fellow creature and so on. God loves us. Our responsibility to love our fellow creatures and so on. Then it gives room to another question. It gives chance to another question. Why will different readers execute the same set of interpretive strategies when faced with the same test? The answer is very simple. The answer is that they belong to the same interpretive communities. Interpretive community. The member of this community are competent readers who share the same literary competence, cultural assumptions, and expectations. The intended reader and the author belong to the same interpretive community. Fish claims that we as individuals interpret texts because each of us is part of an interpretive community that gives us a particular way of reading a text. For example, we are reading a play of Shakespeare. A character speaks some words in an aside. Aside means soliloquy. While reading the play, we do not consider the character to be mad person who assumes the other character on the stage will not hear those words even while the audience can hear them distinctly. And we do not make this assumption because we share the literary competence that the author expects us to have. So as to answer the meaning that the author seeks to convey by noting that these words are spoken as aside. A single reader will employ different interpretive strategies to interpret different literary texts and thus make different texts as he belongs to different communities. For example, let us assume that he is reading Milton, then he belongs to that particular community. Then he is reading John Keats, he belongs to another interpretive community. Nature of interpretive communities. Interpretive communities are no more stable, no more fixed than texts. Interpretive communities are no more stable than texts because interpretive strategies are not natural or universal but learned. The ways of interpreting and those same ways can also be forgotten or supplanted, it means replaced or complicated or dropped from favor, dropped from approval. Unlike the old model of coding and encoding, in Fish's model, meanings are not extracted but they made. So, model's meaning are not extracted but made, and made not by encoded forms but by interpretive strategies that call forms into being. That's all. Thank you very much.